is gas welding, arc welding, and chemical welding. And under non-fusion and pressure welding, it will be with the application of heat and without the application of heat. So in gas welding, there are four subtopics. One is oxyacetylene gas welding, acetylene CTH2 welding, oxy H2 welding, and atomic H2 welding. In arc welding, you will have this AC, DC, then tungsten inert gas welding, metal inert gas welding, and submerged arc welding too. In chemical welding, there will be thermite welding. And in non-fusion pressure welding, there you'll find with and without the application of heat. And with application of heat, it will be resistance welding, brazing, soldering, braze welding. And in resistance welding, again, you'll have the subtopics like water spot welding, seam welding, projection welding, perfusion welding. And this is with regard to with application of heat. And without the application of heat, you'll find this cold pressure welding and cryogenic welding. So this is a main classification with respect to welding. It is fusion and non-fusion. Remember these two. And in fusion, it will be gas welding, arc welding, and chemical welding. In non-fusion welding, it is with the application of heat and without the application of heat. That's it. So I'll be explaining in detail regarding all these classifications. So I'll go on now. So what is fusion welding? Fusion welding is by nothing but by melting up of parent material, if a joint is produced, it is called as fusion welding operation. Okay, and without melting a parent material, if a joint is produced, it will be called as non-fusion welding operation. Okay, so if you melt a parent material and if the joint is produced by melting of the parent material, it is fusion. Without melting of a parent material, if the joint is produced, it will be called as non-fusion welding. And next one is pressure welding. What is pressure welding? If you do the welding process with the application of pressure, of course, if the joint is produced, it is called pressure welding operation. And what is gas welding now? Gas welding is by burning of gas, if the heat required for melting of a plate is obtained, then it will be called as gas welding operation. Next one is arc welding. I'll be just giving just one line explanation, and we'll see in detail in further topics. Okay, I'll just mention you what is gas welding, what is arc welding, what is chemical welding. Just I'll give you this one line explanation, and after five minutes, you'll know we'll go in depth in each and every topic. Okay, so what is arc welding is, if you use an electric arc for melting the plate, then it will be called as arc welding. Okay, so by using an electric arc, if heat required for melting of plate is obtained, then it is called as arc welding. Next one is chemical welding. So by using the exothermic chemical reaction, if the heat required for melting of plate is obtained, then it is called as chemical welding. Next one is resistance welding. So in the case of resistance welding, if the joint is produced with melting a parent material and with the application of pressure. So in resistance welding, there will be two things. You'll be producing a joint by melting a parent material and also with the application of pressure. So this is also considered as fusion pressure welding operation too. Okay. So next one is cold pressure welding. And in cold pressure welding, at room temperature itself, with the application of large amount of pressure, if a joint is produced, even if in the room temperature, with the application of large amount of pressure, if the joint is produced, it will be called as cold pressure welding. Okay, so next one is cryogenic welding. In cryogenic welding, it will be under minus 183 degree centigrade temperature. Okay, so by cooling the metal to a temperature of less than minus 183 degree centigrade, and with the application of large amount of pressure, if the joint is produced, then it will be called as cryogenic welding. Okay, so this I've given all this one line explanations about this fusion, non-fusion pressure welding, and what is gas arc.